Hey everybody, so real quick, I want you to imagine that you're at a dance party, having the time of your life with your friends, having a great time. Well, that wasn't until you got pushed into the middle of a dance circle. You stood there terrified as you realized you had no cool skills to show off. Humiliated, you got shoved back into the dance floor. Imagine the same scenario happening, but this time you knew how to do a cool skill. That is why in this video, I'm going to teach you how to be able to do a backflip. Before you learn anything, you first need some type of mat. The three photos I am showing you right now are what you call an air track. You can use either one of these, a spring floor, which is what I'm bouncing on in this video, a tumble track or a crash mat, which is the green mat I'm leaning on right now. This cushiony mat you see I'm tumbling on in this video is the most commonly used type. The other thing I recommend having is some type of spotter. While having a spotter may not seem very important to you now, I promise you that is the biggest help when learning new skills. The main purpose of a spotter is to help build your confidence and also help you to make sure you don't fall and get hurt. Learning a new skill can be really scary, and I totally understand why you'd be scared, which is why it's a really good idea to have a spotter in case you fall or freak out so they can catch you. Also, always remember to stretch before trying to learn any new skill to reduce your chances of getting hurt.
Oh, that's scary.
The first part of a backflip is called the set. You are going to swing your arms back while keeping your chest up and your head neutral. Next is the bound. You are going to shoot your arms straight up while keeping them straight and trying to keep your head neutral. The bound is what determines how high your backflip will be. After the bound is the beginning of your rotation. As long as you commit to the skill, this will come very naturally. You are going to begin to bring your knees to your chest, and you can either keep your arms to your ears, down to your sides, or you can grab your legs. The next part, at this point, you should be fully rotating. Your knees should be at your chest and your head should still be tucked in, looking basically at your knees. After this, you're going to begin to land. At this point, you can let go of your legs and start flexing your feet so you can land. You are also going to begin to start lifting your chest up to prepare for the actual landing. Once you begin to land, you are immediately going to lift your chest up and stand up all the way. You can also finish like I do, but I do that because I'm a cheerleader. Now that you have the basic understanding of a backflip, you can now start practicing more and more. While learning how to do a backflip, it is very common for yours to possibly look like this. There are a few reasons why your backflip may look like this. Usually it has to do with your set. As you can see in this picture, my arms are really far back and my chest is really far down. This will lead to your bound looking something like this. As you can see, my arms are completely bent, which makes my head throw back because my brain is telling myself to throw my head back because I don't want to get punched in the face by myself. And yes, this is the exact reason why people throw their head back. Also, your back should never be bent over this far. This is about how your rotation is going to look when your bound and set looked the way it just did. There is nothing right with this picture whatsoever, like at all. This is the more common way people get hurt rather than actually doing the skill correctly. As you can see, this is practically a moment before disaster because I look like I'm about to faceplant. I am so glad I have flexible feet also because otherwise they both probably would have been very hurt after this. This right here is an example of why you should stretch before you tumble. Luckily, I remembered at the end to lift my chest up as much as possible no matter what. Because I lifted my chest up is the only reason why I did not faceplant during this video. I flew through the air to save myself. I recommend if you ever do a very interesting looking backflip like this, to always try to land on your feet no matter what, or put your hands out and catch yourself before you faceplant, because faceplanting is the absolute worst. I am now going to go over some things as a review so you will always remember this while doing your backflip. Your bound should always look something like this. This bound right here will set you up for success, always. Also, remember to never throw your head back and to always lift your chest up as much as possible. If you are having trouble with your backflip, maybe I didn't explain something that's going on in the video. Maybe you're not just understanding like what to do. My recommendation is to just always go to a cheer gym, gymnastics gym, somewhere where there's a professional coach. Having a professional coach is way better than even watching a how-to because they can really help you. They can watch you, see what you're doing wrong, what you're doing right. In my opinion, you can learn stuff faster that way. If you're having any other problems, I recommend just going to someone who knows what they're actually doing. with that being said, I'm now going to conclude this video. I hope this video helped you learn something new. And if you did learn something new and you got a really good backflip, share it with your friends, your family, show it off at that dance party in that middle of that dance circle. Maybe you can even teach somebody how to do new skills. If you are ever interested in learning new skills, like I said before, I recommend going to a cheer gym or gymnastics gym where you can learn really cool other skills. And having a professional coach, they can tell you what you can and cannot do next. Again, thank you for watching. I hope you learned something new, and yeah. Too sexy for this girl. Too sexy for this world.